Anyone who knows me and my long-term boyfriend know that we meet a lot of our friends online these days.
We have made a ton of friends in the Disney community, a majority of which we have met on Swingers Upon Main.
This is an app for swingers by swingers, swingers that love Disney. We don't just trade pins at Magic Kingdom. We trade partners.
Oh boy! You can download the app Swing Upon Main today, and maybe we'll see you there.
Introducing a new dating site for Disney adults and those who identify as swingers. It's known as Swingers Upon Main, the dating app for swingers by swingers that love Disney. Because sometimes Mickey wants to take Disney for a spin. And if you couldn't tell, this was a parody. It's not real. Okay, thank God this is not a real thing.
No, at the beginning I could not tell. I'm just because I'm like, you think that it can't happen?
No, it definitely, if you've thought of it, someone's probably already done it.
That's what I was thinking. Yeah. I mean, when I first saw the story, I thought, duck around and find out.
Oh my God, please don't. And if you do, God bless, but don't tell us about it. We don't need to know.
Yeah, because it's pretty goofy.
Yeah. Oh my God, Jake. Okay. So the duo who put that parody together are Grant Gibbs and Ash Gill, also known online as Twink and a Redhead. That video went viral online and has been widely misinterpreted as real. So again, it's parody, it's not real. And it was based on two different conversations that are currently taking place in the country. One has to do with polyamory, which by the way, polyamory and swinging are actually two different things. But someone wrote a book on polyamory and now everyone in the media is like writing pieces and talking about it. And then there's the eternal hatred of the Disney adult that also inspired this parody. Disney adults who range widely in age, sex, and racial background, but are primarily represented in the public imagination by white millennial women, have garnered intense, they've been getting a lot of backlash online, a lot of people making fun of them, with many viewing them as cringe consumerists trapped in a state of perpetual adolescence. Look, I actually think people are a little too hard on the Disney adult. I get the appeal of going to Disneyland or Disney World as an adult with your adult friends or an adult partner, no kids, you go with kids and it's like the most torturous experience you could ever imagine. Cause it's nostalgia, right? You remember what it's like to be a kid again, just for that brief moment in time. But some people do go a little too far with it. So I get why some people criticize them. And while Grant and Ash's video is in fact a parody, it's actually based off a real dating site for Disney adults. Let's watch.
So my husband and I met online, just like a lot of people do nowadays, but our story is a little different. It all started on the site Meet Upon Main.
And here's the adorable part. She was Disney bounding as Ariel in her profile pic, and I was Eric.
A match made in heaven, or at least the Magic Kingdom, which is the same thing to us.
And guess what? We still use Meet Upon Main to make friends with other Disney nerds just like us.
In fact, tomorrow we're meeting up in person with our new Star Wars friends at Batuu.
And it all started with our shared love for Disney. So make your profile at meetuponmain.com today.
You never know who you'll meet.
No, thank you. But Cenk.
Wait, are they just like, I'm being a little dense here. Are they ducking around too?
No, they're still using the dating app to meet new friends.
Friends.
Just friends.
Is it with benefits?
I don't know. I don't know what they're doing. Okay. I don't know what they're sticking it in. I don't care.
Okay.
Like, look, there's someone
this,
for everyone
meet upon
out there.
Main vein? No, okay. So anyways, look, I'm not a Disney person. So in either direction, like some people hate it, I guess, for whatever, because Mickey controls the universe. Yeah, I don't love it. I don't hate it. I like plenty of their programming. My life doesn't revolve around it. No, I mean like in terms of overall Disney, right? Mm-hmm. Like I'm super into Marvel because of my kids, etc. I don't like crowds, Disneyland. But my point is overall, who cares what I'm into? It's whoever, whatever you're into, right? So if they like it, and even if they have sex with goofy outfits on, like literally, right? I don't care.
There's no evidence that they do that.
Some evidence, but anyways, it's called hashtag freedom, hashtag America.
True.
Right? So the people that get upset about it, I think are more bizarre than the people who do it. Like if Somebody wasn't getting dressed up as Daisy Duck and Donald Duck and go to town, right? Like, why would it be my business?
It's not. And I like, that's my main point. It's not our business.
Yeah.
But I feel like everyone, like, look, in the era of social media, people love to overshare. Mm-hmm. So they kind of make it our business.
Yeah, I hear you on that.
And
yeah.
So I don't want to be judgmental, and I'm not being judgmental. They can do whatever they want. It's just not for me. It's for other people, right?
Yeah.
The whole thing about like, profile pic dressed as Ariel, and I was dressed, I don't forget what he said he was dressed as. It's like,
yeah.
You know, I get the need for nostalgia, wanting to feel like a kid again. It's escapism, right?
Yeah.
Don't let it take over too much of your life. That's the only thing. Because then it can become, you know, it could be
harmful. I thought you were
gonna
go in a different direction. Like, some of the characters like are like dressed up as Ariel. Is that an issue? Since she's younger? I don't know. The dwarves present a different problem.
Prince Eric can get it. Like, let's all acknowledge that Prince Eric can get it. Tall, dark, handsome, super hot.
Okay.
But
I just realized the one they're most into. But anyway, go ahead.
Which one?
I mean, if they're gonna get into the sex thing, they're gonna get into the Beauty and the Beast. Because the Beast is, you know, that's gonna be a thing.
So
it's gonna be a thing, you know it is.
So Meet Upon Main, which was the inspiration for the parody video that Grant and Ash put together, launched in the fall of 2022. And they boast the slogan, find your magical match. In an interview with Rolling Stone, the co-creators said that they initially intended for it to be a dating app targeted at members of the Disney, Star Wars, and Marvel fandoms. But it has since evolved into a general networking platform for those looking to befriend fellow theme park aficionados.
Well, look here, I was just thinking, okay, yeah, but what am I into, right? So when I was a kid, I loved Star Trek. So if you said to me, hey, do you wanna date someone who also loves Star Trek? I'd be like, no, I don't care at all. On the other hand, now that I'm a grown up, hold on.
Okay, all right, I'm listening.
And somebody said, hey, they're into Succession and Fargo and all the different shows you're into. Are you interested in them? I'm like, I kind of am. Because that means we're more like-minded, right? And we probably get along better and we probably could have better conversations. We could enjoy the same things together. When you look at it that way, it begins to make sense.
Sure, yeah. I mean, look, it's like-minded individuals looking for either friendship or love with people who have similar interests. The Disney adult thing, little obsessive, but whatever. Just do you and don't let it overtake your life. That's it.
Fair. And Little Mermaid, gonna be problematic, but you'll figure it out.
If you enjoyed this video, that's because of our members. They make us independent, they make us strong, and they make us honest. Become a member today by hitting the join button below.